do a overnight camp out here, kind of land between the lakes. This is Catawba Landing camping area. It's not a bad little site. I'm just going to go ahead and get stuff set up. Thank you. I don't think anybody wants to watch the entire tent set up, so I'll go ahead and get back to you in a bit. Go ahead and get the bedding all set up, good to go. Once we get this done, have to go get some firewood so we can get that ready to go too. It's already 3 in the afternoon. I'll make sure I've got everything good to go before it gets dark. And in case it actually gets cold tonight, it's not supposed to, but if it does, I've got my extra wool blanket here, so should be good to go. Warm weather sleeping bag. It's already to 50 degrees, so it's not super warm, but it's only supposed to be, I think it was 60 tonight, so should be plenty. Well, like I said, just in case, I do have a blanket. Weather forecasting is not exactly real accurate all the time. Got my little pillow here. Just a real cheap, basic travel pillow that I stuffed in a stuff sack. Good to go. I already scouted out previously. There's some firewood down by the beach down here. It's already really dry and looks like it'd be good firewood, so I'm gonna head down that way and grab as much as I can. I'll come get you and take you down here with me. See some of the firewood and some of the view. Nice. It's quieter than a few boats. Here's my own little private beach. Looking out over the lake. Won't get a view of the sunset from this side, but that's okay. Couldn't find a good spot on the other side and the other lakes that are facing west, so just had to settle for this one. But here's what I'm looking for firewood. I think that should make a good amount, and then I'll see if I can find some more after that. But for now, I'm gonna go ahead and get started on it. Got my Silky Gombo here. Should make pretty short work of that. Let's see what we can do. Giant hornet there. Don't really want to visit by him. Advice, don't choose to cut through a knot. I'm going to go ahead and haul this stuff up to camp. And I'll process up some more. I'm gonna breathe it for a minute too. All right, let's go ahead and we'll just walk down the shoreline a little bit, and we'll see if we can find some more firewood. Got all that other stuff taken up to camp, so it can be processed up at least. lots of other little pieces down here. I'm hoping to find some other good sized pieces that I can cut up or break up that haven't been in water in a long time. Doesn't look real promising here. Probably gonna have to actually go up in there and see what I can find. Alright, well, I'm gonna go throw the camera back up in camp because I don't want to drag it around while I'm looking for stuff. I'll get back to you when I got some more wood.
Got some previous people use this fire pit. I'm gonna use it, but I'm gonna dig it out a bit so it's not such a mound of ash and garbage and every other thing that they've thrown in here. Get some more rocks if I need to. Should be plenty around here.
I'll put me a fire pit that's bonfire size.
It's just me, so I gotta cook for an army or something.
Size for me.
Nothing crazy, because I don't need anything crazy.
Unfortunately, it's good and dry in the bottom, so probably shouldn't be a problem. I just got to finish cutting up all this wood that I got. See, I got a pretty good pile. I got some medium and larger stuff over here, and some smaller stuff here. I'll go around and pick up some little handfuls and stuff for some smaller kindling. That should give me a plenty to get all set up for when I need the fire. It's still too early for that now, but eventually I'll get to it. I'm almost done processing wood here. Got my big stuff over there, just a few for tonight. My little kindling and starter wood, and some mediums and some bigger mediums, and just got a few more pieces to cut up here, and that should finish off for what I'm cutting up anyway. I'm only here for a night, so I don't need to cut up a ton. I just want to make sure I've got enough for dinner and a nice little fire tonight and breakfast in the morning. I think that about wraps it up for wood processing anyway. I'll get back to you in a bit. Yeah, got her all laid out and ready. Get some feather sticks here. More curls than feather sticks, but hope they work. Come on, focus. Oh, you get the idea. Decent little pile of them, should be enough. Now just a matter of waiting until it's time. I may lay the piles out a little bit different just to make it a little easier for setup and grab, but till then we'll see. Hoping I might get some sunset here. We'll see. I'm hoping so. There's my neighbors over there. There's one other person over on the other side of the point. But there's nobody on this side. I got the only spot. Take a little walk down this little beach area and check it out. Before it gets dark anyway. So I was wandering, just kind of looking around. What do I find here? Well, let's see. We got deer. That's not deer. What is that? Coyote, maybe? I don't know. There's no wolves here, supposedly. I mean, it's Western Kentucky. I hear coyotes all the time, so it's probably all it is. Looks like it was following the deer. That was kind of interesting. Probably lots of them around here. We'll see if we get any visitors later. It's possible. Yeah, it's nice just sitting down here by the water for a little bit. I'm gonna walk back up to my camp because the sun blaring on me. It's starting to get a little warm. So I'll just take you with me on the walk back. It's not very far. Probably a bit shaky. I don't have a fancy gimbal or anything like that. Just my old Nikon camera. And here we are. I'll bring you back when there's something else to see or talk about.
Hey, everybody. I figured since I'm just sitting here not really doing much else, I'd tell you a little bit about me. I started camping with my mom when I was probably about 7 or 8 years old. She's the one that taught me a lot of my bushcraft skills that I have now that I never knew that's what it was called. And she taught me, you know, basic fire making, shelter making, of course. But then she also taught me different plants and animals and how a lot of them can be used. All this was back in Western Washington, which is where I grew up. I was there until I was 19 and then went in the military. And then, of course, that took me away from there. And I spent the next 12 years in North Dakota. A little different world for outdoor stuff up there. Really cold in the winter, really hot in the summer. Not a whole lot of fun places to go, but I still camped up there a little bit when I could. After that, I ended up moving to Nebraska, another place that doesn't really have a whole lot of forests or things to do like that. Not like I grew up with, you know, the giant evergreens and all that fun type of thing. So I just kind of did some stuff, little hikes, things like that, nothing crazy. And then once I retired, I ended up moving out to Kentucky. That's where I've got family at. And got a job and whatnot. And kind of started exploring some of the areas. And we've got land between the lakes here. I mean, it's a really huge national recreation area. It's got lots of different campgrounds. And of course, it's got Lake Barkley and Kentucky Lake. This campground is actually on the Lake Barkley side. And of course, I thought I wasn't going to get sun, but as you can see, I've got sun right in my face. Didn't really plan on that, but I should get a decent sunset to see at least. That'll be nice. Right now, it's, let's see, 20 after 5. Been a little over 2 hours and just been kind of relaxing. I find it kind of funny. I'm talking on video now, and I like to watch Joe Robinette. He's one of the big people that gave me this idea, and I hear an airplane, and his videos are famous for always having airplanes in the background. That's just kind of funny. There's only a couple other people out here at the spot, so it's been really quiet. Even though they have some kids, other kids being kids, but nothing crazy. And I think it'll be a nice, peaceful spot to be in, and I'll probably actually come back to this spot again. Might bring the wife next time if she wants to go. It's up to her. Maybe someday I can bring my son. You know, if he ever comes out and visits, and he'd probably like to come out here too. Next time I'd like to get out here a bit earlier so I can go do some hiking and kind of check out the area a bit more, walk the edge of the lake, and do a bit of exploring. I know this isn't a typical bushcraft video. I mean, I'm obviously sitting in a camp chair. I didn't build some chair out of wood and all that crazy stuff. I could have. I just didn't want to take the time because I already got here so late. I spent almost 5 hours trying to find a place that had space. The weather's supposed to be so nice this weekend that everybody's out camping. So I just had to keep driving and driving and came to this place. It's kind of a bit harder to find than some of the other ones. A lot of gravel roads to get out here. But I find it. There's only two other people, so that's where I'm at. I found another spot earlier that I had contemplated. It was right on a beach. It's off of one of the major hiking trails for LBL. But there was already maybe 10 or 15 other tents there in the woods, on the edge. And no cars, so I'm assuming they were all hikers. One of the big things about Lamatune Lakes, there's a lot of cemeteries all over the place. Well, cemetery's no big deal, but that last campsite was literally right next to one. Personally, I don't like that. I don't think that's appropriate to have people having recreation right next to a cemetery. It's not scary or creepy or anything like that. I think it's kind of disrespectful. So I chose not to go there. Some of the other ones, I liked some of the spots they had, but the spots that I liked were taken. They have a tendency to make random spots here that are just off the side of the road. You have like a picnic table and a fire ring on the edge of a cliff, and that just didn't do it for me. I don't need a table. This site happens to have one. I probably won't use it except for just setting stuff on it. No real need. They had a fire pit that somebody had made in the past, and as you saw, I just cleaned it up a bit. Made it a little smaller for me. But other than that, I'm not really doing a whole lot of crafty bushcraft stuff today. I might do a little bit tomorrow just to show how to make some stuff. Depends. I don't know what time I'll get out of here. Open-ended is whenever. Where I'm at right now, I live basically right on the other side of the lake from here, but it's still over an hour to get here, just because the route you have to drive to get here is kind of goofy. And like I said, a lot of gravel roads. They're not roads you can go very fast on. They're very narrow, windy, a lot of blind corners and blind hills. And so I just take my time and kind of watch for wildlife. On my drive, you know, I was watching, and the only things I saw was lots of squirrels, one turkey, and the butt of a white-tailed deer as it ran off. Hoping maybe some deer will come down to the water here and I can catch a little video of them, but we'll see. I mean, they may not. And if I see any other wildlife, you know, I'll try to catch it on camera too. So one of the things I like to do is take pictures. Started taking video, of course, obviously. And, I hope you enjoy the stuff that I have to share with you. And before too long here, I'll probably go ahead and see if I can get the fire going. I'm going to try using fire steel, which I fully understand how it works. I've played with it at home, but I have never actually started a campfire with fire steel. I've done lots of other methods, but not that method, so I wanted to do it. I made sure to find some really good dry wood and made all the shavings and kind of some little feather sticks in there too. And it's all set up, so we'll see if I can get it going. And if I can't get it going that way, I do have a lighter, so I, you know, won't go without fire. So I can still make dinner and have a nice little fire to sit around later. Not one to talk a whole lot. Don't really know what else I should talk about, but for now I think I'm just gonna sit and just kind of enjoy nature, and I'll come back to you either when sunset looking nice or when I go to start the fire, whichever one comes first. I mean, it kind of just depends on how I feel. Alright, see you then.
see if we can get this thing started. It looks a lot brighter on the camera than it actually is out here, so.
The driest wood in the world. Looked dry, felt dry, but not catching real well. All the times you see these videos where it looks like super easy, it's not that easy. I'm not sure if I had birch bark or super dry resiny wood would be great, but no pine trees around here close. I mean, there's some up the road. Well, I think I'm just going to admit defeat. Just use the lighter. Super dry.
Some of the bigger ones here. Work my way up in size until I can get the big ones on there. So I can start working in the coals. That way I can dinner in a bit.
She's going. This is probably one of the best parts of camping right here, sitting by the fire. Well, it's morning. I think it's around, it's almost 6:30 now. Had a little tiny fire this morning just to kind of take the chill off. See, it's just starting to get light. I don't know if you can see it on the camera or not. But I'm going to hang out here by the fire for a little bit. And what's left of it is just basically coals now.
Hang out.
wait for daylight. Once the sun comes on up, then I'll go ahead and pack up and probably just head home. Got some stuff I gotta do today, so I'll stay out here all day. It's a nice quiet night other than all the fish jumping. Lots and lots of big fish right by here. Other than that, just crickets and frogs and about it. Nice place. I'll definitely come back to this spot again. And, I'll get back to you when I start tearing stuff down. At this point, you get the idea. I'm gonna go ahead and finish tearing her down and there we go. Alrighty, she's all taken down. All I got left is my chair here. Alright, I think I'm just gonna sit for a little bit by the dying embers of my fire here and just kind of relax and listen to the lake for a little bit. Got some geese and other birds and heading out here before too long. Sit down and do it for a few minutes while I can. And, hopefully you enjoy the video. If you do, remember to like, subscribe, share, and if you hit the little notification bell, you'll get a notification and an email anytime I upload a new video. I'm still going to try to do them once a week. It won't always be like this. Some of them will be just basic bushcraft skills that I'm demonstrating at home. I do plan on still building a bushcraft shelter out on a piece of property that my mom has. And I've also got some woods near my house that I'm going to see if I can use those as well. Hope to bring some more skills to you, show you some more of my outdoors, and hope to see you next time.